Okay, I got one bee out here. It seems like he's doing all the work. Now that I'm recording, he's just, okay, see, he got on top of them flowers over there. And now he's back over by the back. But he's been going through all these flowers out here, and some of these plants look so horrific. I mean, they have diseased leaves. I'm pulling them off, and as you can see, the rest of them look okay. So I'm not really hurting or damaging. If it seemed like it was hurting them, I would stop doing that. But they get brown spot or yellow spots on them or something, and I pull them off as quickly as I can. That one's dying off. I don't think it'll make it. That one there has had some brown spots on it before a lot, and I took them off, and it's green. It seems okay. But then look at the others. Everything out here was planted within about 2 weeks of each other. I took pictures starting from the left, which would be the furthest west, from south to north. And I come over a row from south to north. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. Well, 6 if you want to count this little one down there by itself in this row. We got tomato plants that we could put out here that are... From a sliced tomato, my wife put in potting soil, and you should see them all sprouting up. There's pictures of that. A grow light is actually helping also. I believe it helps, but you know, my brother in Chicago or Elwood, whatever you want to say, suggested about putting a slice of tomato in the soil and the tomatoes would grow. But you know, you can't put them out like that because they'd all be right on top of one another. You know, 12 tomatoes growing in one little area. So we're getting ready to split them up and see if we can put them in different little pots. No more than two in one little pot, quart-sized pot, but I'd like to put one in each one. So with the tomatoes we have out here, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 that I see that are growing really good. Of the 12, there's like 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with tomatoes on them. This is like a plum tomato too. Let me see it right in the center there. I suggest anybody watching something like this, always put it on like your full screen and watch it. And then if you don't want to stop it, you can stop it that way. But I mean, watching on a little screen it's okay, but you want to get a real good view of what it looks like. You know, I'd suggest full screen. So. Oh, the watermelons over there are like, man. I'm telling you what, we got so many watermelons with long ones and a bunch of, mainly the sugar babies, the round ones. They're really, really, really sweet. That's why I call them sugar babies, I guess. Year before last, we had one that was 19 pounds. And I think we kind of took it off. We could have let it lay on the vine a little bit longer, but we took it off. 19 pounds. Let me go right here to see. Anyway, I was just looking, trying to see the time on this screen. It is a Sony, so you know, yeah. Anyway, I'm trying not to cuss because, you know, people should just watch this and giggle or whatever. You know, this may not be the best to some of you, but, you know, to the others, you realize that this is really a good, good little garden here. The beans are dying off for some reason. Again, I don't know anything about this, so every year I just do it. And I don't study. After I do it, I'm like, oh, this is why this happened. I just till up my ground, I put in 15, 15, 15 fertilizer and till it in, and then the plastic, which we are not taking the plastic off no more. It's just almost killed us this last time to take this plastic off. Again, I'm just going approximate measurements. From west to east, it's about 60 feet, and from south to north, it's about 30 feet, approximately, okay? And in the back, I'd say about 18 feet by about 12 feet. 18 feet east to west, 12 feet from south to north. And those two gardens. Number one over there, which is the zucchini and the okra, are really starting to take off. The zucchini is covering everything over there right now. We've already gotten about 6 or 8 large ones, and maybe another 12 or 15 that are the size or a little bit bigger than the ones you get in the store. I'm not walking all the way over there though. And some of my sunflowers are coming up here. Two different types of sunflowers too. You can see by just looking at the flower head. This one's got multiple heads on here. I think this might be a Titan. I'm not sure if it's Titan or what it is. Or again, they're all heirloom, so they have so many different names. I just know that tall one there is about 7 foot right now. That's a mammoth. This tall one right here in the corner is a Titan. I know that. But the rest of them, like I said, the ones that are flowering right now. And amazingly, these were seeds that were in the ground already. That's why we just let them go. We've gone been mowing around and whatnot. But the ones I planted around the garden, because of the Monsanto spray, trash, crap, whatever you want to call it, it's killed them off so many times. I've replanted, and now look at them. This is June, I don't know, 22nd, maybe? No, 23rd. I think it is the 23rd. And, you know, again, you know, it's that trash. It's that food-like product that so many people eat blindly. Well, this corn is going to be for feed. It's going to be feed corn. So that means we'll have some nasty horse flies and deer flies out here this summer. So, but, yeah, this is a lot of work. It is. I'm not going to lie to anybody. But it's satisfying because, you know, you're getting free. You're getting clean and fresh food. And when I say clean, considering the crap you buy in the store, it's clean, okay? Stuff you buy in the store, they have to spray it, they have to wash it, and they do so much with it just for it to stay in a store for a week or two, you know, come on. And you go to a farmer's market, and even then, they're using Monsanto a lot of times. These are heirloom seeds from Heirloom Solutions, and everything I've ever planted from one seed has grown. My mom used to put down 2 or 3 seeds of purple hull peas and whatnot to grow, you know, 2 or 3 plants, I guess, but I would put one pea down, and one plant would grow. I went ahead and put down 2 or 3, and they're strangling themselves over there now because they all come up. The tomatoes, that's the one. They always thought it's the easiest thing to grow. Yeah, try it out here, you know, where we have the winds from hell. So we have to let them get so large before we can even bring them out here. Right there would be a small one, which most people wouldn't even put out, but we put that one out after it grew in the house. That's about 10 inches tall. I mean, seriously, I mean, I almost want to make them like that tall right there. That's about 24 inches right there. But that's too big to keep in a pot. So, you know, we've been putting them out like that, about 10 inches or so. But, you know, I'm checking these out, making sure that there's no insects, disease. This one looked like it started to have that brown spot on that tomato right there. It was darker, and then it started getting lighter and lighter, and I was going to pluck it, because it says if you get a brown spot on there, you got to get it off. But see, it's getting better. So, and then we got more tomatoes just growing all over here. And then that bee, which I'm in its way over here now, so I'm going to go in the house here. The leaves are curled. Usually it's from too much water. That's the main thing, but we have no control over man, God, and the weather that they produce. We watered it. If it's going to be like 7 days without rain, and there's no rain forecast for about 2 days or 3 days past that, we give it a good soaking. But no sooner than 5 days, I should say, okay? But it's got to be like 3 or 4 days after that with no signs of rain. But it's been wet out here. You know, we've had floods out here. As you can see, the dried dirt right there. That's where it floods in the garden, where the light dirt is. But look at the bean right there, man. I mean, and I don't understand why. They were really good, and all of a sudden they're not. So it's possibly that stuff right there. All that stuff up there in the air that we're breathing. Go out at night sometime with a flashlight, preferably a high beam one, because it'll be more intense. And look at all the particles that are coming down. It looks like a sleet. Honestly, God, it looks like sleet coming down at a constant pace. Now, that's at night when you can see it. See, if I have a real powerful flashlight, which I don't know how I'd get one that powerful during the daytime to do the same thing. Because right now, the same thing, it's pelting us right now. You know, just think of invisible radiation. It's not really invisible. The particles are just so small you can't see it. But, I attribute that directly to the stuff that's going wrong with these plants, especially these heirlooms. They're not Monsanto that's genetically modified to fight chemicals and bugs and whatever. Now, it's genetically modified to fight that stuff, and then you eat that. Well, not me, but a lot of people. Europe won't take 85% of our produce because of that fact, but they won't say that because, you know, big business, folks. Don't you dare say anything about Monsanto or any of the chemical companies, Dow or Bayer. One thing you don't say is the chosen ones. Same thing against Israel on MSNBC C-SPAN or MS-13 NBC span, and you say anything about Israel and Jew, and boom, they hang up on your phone right away. So it's the same thing, folks. You know who it is. I'm not afraid to say it. I don't give a crap. I'm not going to, because I'll start swearing, because I get really aggravated. When I get aggravated, I start cussing big time, so I'm going to get off of that. But I would almost wager, I would be about 85, 90% sure a lot of the stuff that's bad with the plants and all that is because of the crap that's rained down into the ground. No control really I have with that, not me anyway. If I had the money, I'd have a greenhouse. I have a 100 by 50 foot greenhouse right now. And, actually, I have to have bigger than that for what we grow. And if we had a 100 by 50 foot greenhouse, we wouldn't even grow about at least a third of this stuff wouldn't be able to fit in there. We'd have to have like 500 feet by 200 feet, 250. And then we could grow things in it. And we'd have to water it with water from the ground, which that stuff rains down into the ground, gets into the well water, and then that's the stuff you use. But I put mine through a filter, except for the garden hose. I can't filter that because I don't have the money for that. So I don't drink any tap water. If it's not filtered, I have a big Berkey water filter. I've got two extra filters right now, brand new filters that'll last me for another 8 years, 10 years. And this one, the two I have right now, should last me for another 3 to 4 years. So, and by that time I'll probably be dead anyway. Boo. Yeah, but look at these sunflowers. I mean, yeah, they get disease and such and all that, but when the optimal weather is not good because of the water that's getting, it's depleted of this and that. Look at the trees. Look at the gray bark on there, the moss, if you want to call it moss. Been here for 6.5 years, almost 6.5 years now. Never had that on these trees. Look at that one over there by the driveway. Look at that gray on the bark. Oh, it's just moss, yeah. You know, what happens is a lot of this stuff, I don't even know all the words anymore that's in the rain. Everybody always just says, aluminum, which is a major thing. You know, if you look out and you see a mist and all that, that's not mist. That's what you're breathing, folks. It's not like, oh, dude. Yeah, it's crap is what it is. Well, again, I digress. You're being sprayed. You don't care. You know, I mean, just do some things you can for the family, your family. But I'm just suggesting things that I try to do. I try. And it's not great, but it's better than 90% of what's out there. Again, full screen, panoramic view. God, flies are, I've been bad this year too. Okay, this is east over here. 360 acres of Monsanto food-like product out here. And I'm just gonna go to west, directly west. The sun should be setting at night, right there. I did a video yesterday. It's set over there, northwest. You know, but it's fine. Don't worry about it. Everything's fine. Go back to sleep, dumbass. Well, I had to say it. You're being poisoned, and silence is consent. So, if you don't get up and look at the sun and you get a compass and you see that west is there, but the sun is setting northwest, and you don't think there's anything wrong with that, that's fine. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So, do me one favor. Don't ever, ever, ever even consider the thought of coming anywhere around me. I don't have time for stupid. It's my biggest hate, and I do mean hate. Stupid. I've tried to show things to people, helping them, and when they don't do it, baseball bat, skull, baseball bat, knee, ring a bell. That's it.